We'll practice playing the computer, and we'll review the iteration pattern that you've seen a few times, and we'll talk about why order matters in iteration. That's the most important part of today's lesson. Okay, so today we're going to be working with notes, and here's the iteration pattern. You've seen this a few times. It's where I set a variable, I repeat some number of times, and then inside of that repeat, I use the variable. So here I'm using the variable note, and I change that variable. Okay, so it has a set, a repeat, inside I use the variable and change the variable. Both of these count as the iteration pattern. See, the only difference is in what order I change the variable and what order I use the variable. So here we go. Let's look at this first one where I set the note to 60, and then the first note that I play is 60, and then I change the note by 2. So that's like this set of scripts. I'm going to play 5 notes. I start with 60, I change it by 2, then I play 62, I change it by 2, play 64, change it by 2, play 66, change it by 2, play 68, change it by 2. And so in the end, the last note I played was 68, just like the script below. The variable note will be 70. Let's listen. This next one, it looks almost exactly the same, except for the order is different here between play note and change note. First, let's play computer and figure out exactly what the computer would do. So first, I set the note to 60, and I'm going to repeat 5 times. I change the note by 2. So before I've played the note, I change note, which is 60, by 2, making it 62. So here, when I first play a note, the first note I play is 62. Then from there, I'm going to change the note by 2, making it 64, play 64, and I play these 5 notes. So you can look, it's offset. This one on the left plays notes 60 through 68. This one on the right plays notes 62 through 70. Let's listen to the one on the right. And again, the one on the left. Let's look at it with drums, and it'll be a little bit easier to hear. So here I have the iteration pattern again, except instead of playing note, I'm playing a drum. Drums have different options, so here I have all the different drum options. Here I set the drum to 1, I repeat 5 times, I play drum 1, then I change it by 3. So I start by playing drum 1, the next time I'll play drum 4, then 7, then 10, then 13. Let's listen, and watch how drum changes. Cool sounding, huh? Okay, this one, it's just like before, where now I'm going to put the change first. So I set drum to 1, and then right away, I change drum by 3, and making it 4. So the first drum that I play is 4, and then I play 4, 7, 10, 13, and 16. So you should hear drum 16, which is the we go. You should hear that one in the one on the right, but not on the left. Let's listen to it first. Okay, so let's listen for that one here. You should hear drum 16 in this script on the right. Okay, but we don't hear it when we play the script on the left. For both of them, the drum variable ends up being 16. But which drum we play first varies based upon whether the change happens first in the repeat or after this play drum. The iteration pattern can help us solve a lot of different problems. It's really important. And remember that to get better at computer science, you just have to practice.